wondering, okay, so if our property value, I'm thinking within this new school and the money poured in, our property values will go up. So then we're going to be paying more money because our property values go up, right?
No.
Okay.
And I mean, it's a mathematical formula.
I don't do that.
Okay. That's why I use my wife and friends. But let me, there's a total amount we have to pay. Right now, our property, the total district property valuation is around $608 million. So let's say our property values, because of passing this bond, go up to $700 million. The amount you pay will go down because we pay a fixed amount on the bonds annually.
Oh, so it will be a fixed amount. So in 20 years, we would still be paying just the dollar?
No, we would pay the fixed amount on the bond issue. So let's say we're paying of the 12.5, well, let's do this math. Let's divide 20 into 12.5 million. So if there was a 10-year bond, it would be approximately $110. Where your taxes could go down is if there's additional growth in the community, that there's a housing development, and all of a sudden we have $5 million worth of new property. New property, new development will lower your taxes. If not one single house is built in 20 years, or not one single business comes in 20 years, and your property valuations go up 3% a year, which they can through Oregon, you know, by law, then while your property valuations go up 3%, the amount you pay towards the bond will go down approximately 3%, but the total amount you pay will be the same.
Let's pause at this moment. For those interested in further intricacies of the mathematics, I'm sure you are available.
Thank you, Michael.